Okay, so Tom is going to be first. I'm going to mute everybody. Here we go.
Okay, so I guess we're ready to start. And I would like to do a Mance Lipscomb tune. I don't know who wrote this song. It's an oldie and a goodie. Called Nighttime Is the Right Time. Time be with the one you love. When you're out late at night, babe, you know I can't rest. Even the food I eat, honey, babe, it won't digest. And nighttime is the right time to be with the one you love. I grabbed my hat this morning, she followed me to the door. She said, good die, bad, I hate to see you go. Nighttime is the right time, be with the one you love, with the one you love. Last night and I cried the whole night long. I cried last night, I cried the whole night long. I didn't miss my baby until she had gone. You ain't gonna miss your water till your well go dry. Ain't gonna miss your loved one till she say goodbye. Nighttime is the right time, be with the one you love, with the one you love. She don't see me. Nighttime is the right time, be with the one you love, with the one you love. Some train and ride, but when a woman take the blues, she hangs her head and cries. Nighttime is the right time, be with the one you love, with the one you So this next number, folks, is my arrangement of La Paloma, the dove, instrumental arrangement.
Okay, next up is Branson.
Good evening. Patty. How's everyone doing?
Hold on, Branson. Okay, now you can unmute yourself. There you go.
There we go. Good evening. How you doing tonight, Ellen? I hope you're working on that memoir. Trying to talk Ellen into writing us a story. Well, this is, stage death, I guess, but... back-to-back guitar instrumentals. ¶¶
All right.
Lovely.
Awesome.
Thank you very much. Pardon me for tuning in. We'll get back into standard here. Play you something old time. Forgot where I was. Let's try this again. Oh. I'm sorry. It's just out of my head. I forgot how to play it. Let's move on. Thank you very much.
I need to fix my camera, so that's why I'm kind of frozen here.
You could play a different one, Bronson.
Yeah, you want to just play another one? We're playing
just another one.
Nah, let's move along. I think that's fine for tonight. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Well, Linda.
Okay, I need to just sign in on the iPhone here.
And after Linda will be Tom Maynard. So I will mute and unmute, and then I will fix my camera.
Okay, Dan, I'm taking it to the piano. So this is a song that I actually didn't finish writing till last night, and it's sort of gone viral to my shock. It's like, with all that's been happening in the world, sometimes I just sit with it, and I feel like musicians are often creative alchemists and take both the inner and the outer feelings of what's going on and transmute them into gold in a way that people can really relate to it. And that's what's happened with this song. It's called All One Human Race. And I actually got a national radio DJ who saw it on Facebook who asked for an MP3 to play it on his radio show tonight, which was a real surprise. So, All One Human Race.
A good one, Linda. It really is.
Thank you.
Very nice.
So I thought we'd only have one, so I'll quote another one from the Sheltering at Home collection called Kindness, which is something that I think we really need to be focused on these days.
Touch, hold me Beautiful, Linda. Beautiful.
Thank you, Linda. Okay. Next up is Tom Maynard. After Tom will be Deb Goss. So 1 second. Okay, and you can unmute yourself, Tom.
Thanks, Dan. I'm going to do a couple of covers. The first one's a Lyle Lovett song. I actually learned it from someone who covered it from him, and it was part of a soundtrack for, I think, the movie I Am Sam. I'm blanking on the woman's name who covered it, but it's more in that style. It's called If I Had a Boat. If I had a boat, I'd go out on the ocean. And if I had a pony, I'd ride him on my boat. And we would all together go out on the ocean, me upon my pony on my boat. And if I were Roy Rogers, I'd sure enough be single. Couldn't bring myself to marry an old Dale. It'd just be me and Trigger. We'd go riding through the movies. Then I'd buy a boat, and on the sea we'd sail. And if I had a boat, I'd go out on the ocean. And if I had a pony, I'd ride him on my boat. And we would all together go out on the ocean, me upon my pony on my boat. The mystery masked man was smart. He got himself a Tonto, 'cause Tonto did the dirty work for free. But Tonto, he was smarter. One day said Kimosabi, kiss my ass, I bought a boat, I'm going out to sea. And if I had a boat, I'd go out on the ocean. And if I had a pony, I'd ride him on my boat. And we could all together go out on the ocean, me upon my pony on my boat. If I were like lightning, I wouldn't need no sneakers. I'd come and go wherever I would please. I'd scare them by the shade tree, and I'd scare them by the light pole. But I would not scare my pony on my boat out on the sea. And if I had a boat, I'd go out on the ocean. And if I had a pony, I'd ride him on my boat. And we could all together go out on the ocean, me upon my pony on my boat. Me upon my pony. And I thought I'd do an old Jerry and the Pacemakers tune. Don't. Oh, that's a bad key, sorry. I gotta get the right key. Ha ha. the sun, catch you crying. The night's the time for your tears. Your heart may be broken tonight, but tomorrow in the morning light, don't let the sun catch you crying. The nighttime shadows disappear. And with them go all your tears. For the morning will bring joy for every girl and boy. So don't let the sun catch you crying. We know that crying's not a bad thing, but stop your crying when the birds sing. It may be hard to discover, that you've been left for another. But don't forget that love's a game, and it'll always come again. Oh, don't let the sun catch you crying. Don't let the sun catch you crying, oh no.
Oh. It's fun to sing along at home with.
Yeah, I used to harmonize with that like every time it came on the radio.
Absolutely, yeah.
Sang along, it was one of those ones.
The one we need to hear occasionally.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Okay, Deb is up next.
Oh, my. Okay.
Oh, my. And Ron is not here yet, so we'll slot him in when he gets here after 8. So Mike Centoro will be after Deb. So let me mute. And Deb, you can unmute yourself. You're still muted. You are still muted, Deb.
I am. I thought I unmuted and then
now you're fine.
Again. Mm-hmm. Okay, so let's see. All right, I'm just going to pick one from Rise Up Singing that I used to know. And I just hope that the letters are big enough that I get all the words right. And if I can remember it. Sons of the sea, sons of the saint, who is the child with no complaint? Sons of the great and sons unknown, all were children like your own. The same sweet smiles, the same sad tears, the cries at night, the nightmare fears. Sons of the great and sons unknown, all were children like your own. So long ago, long, long ago. Sons of tycoons and sons from the farms, All of the children ran from your arms, through fields of gold, through fields of ruin. All of the children vanished too soon in towering waves, walls of flesh, amid dying birds, trembling with death. Sons of tycoons and sons from the farms, all of the children ran from your arms so long ago, long, long ago. Sons of your sons and sons passing by, children were lost in lullaby. Sons of true love, sons of regret, all of your sons you can never forget. Some built roads, some wrote the poems, some went to war, and some never came home. Sons of your sons, sons passing by, children were lost in lullaby. Long, long ago, so long ago, sons of the great and sons unknown, all were children like your own, long, long ago, so long ago. Now, that's not quite the way it's supposed to go. And it's kind of sad. It's just about how, you know, stuff never changes.
Sounded fine.
But once in a while, we have a good day, like today when the Supreme Court said something nice to us. Thank you very much. People get to have their jobs, no matter who they are, we hope. Yeah, that one, I don't know. There's something comforting and sad at the same time about that song. So that was the American version of Jacques Brel's song. Now this is going to be, I'm going to sing a Terry Haggerty song, a Terrence Haggerty song, and it's a cheerful one.
Wow.
So this is the quick cheerful one. I sang it earlier this year. I hope I can get it right now. So it's not enough to know how much you care. It's not enough to give more than your share. It's not enough to spread joy everywhere. You've got to say the word. It's not enough to wish upon a star. It's not enough to take two steps too far. It's not enough to think, therefore you are. You've got to say the word. And if you can't feel it ringing in your ears, don't try to conceal it when it wells up with your tears. It's not enough to cry out in the night. It's not enough to nearly die of fright. It's not enough to see that blinding light. You've got to say the word. And if you can't feel it ringing in your ears, don't try to conceal it when it wells up with your tears. It's not enough to cry out in the night. It's not enough to nearly die of fright. It's not enough to see that blinding light. You've got to say the word.
Amazing.
That's my song that I sing when I'm trying to say something specific and not be too general about it. Thanks for listening. I'm sorry I didn't sing earlier in the day. Sometimes I sing earlier in the day and I know what I'm doing, but
no, you sounded fine.
Wasn't one of those days. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Deb. Next up is Mike Santoro, and following Mike will be Ellen. So 1 second. Okay, Mike, you can unmute yourself whenever you are ready. Here you are. Unmuted. Let's see, I don't know this volume. Okay, you can see me, you can hear me.
Yep.
So this is a song I wrote. It's a divorce song, not my divorce, but it's a divorce. I was thinking of putting myself in the position of a man who has had a divorce, and he's thinking about his daughter, how the divorce affected his daughter. So. Pressed against the window, that little girl that I once held. I'm only leaving 'cause I have to. But your daddy loves you. He loves you like he always did. Daddy loves you, he loves you like he always did. Can't expect that you could understand the reasons. Sometimes I can't understand myself. My heart was already broken that day when your heart was breaking. Breaking my little one. And the pencil marks I make on the wall in the kitchen. They mark the growth of my young girl. And sometimes I felt the anger that was growing from your pain. So that's supposed to be the most famous guitar riff. I've got sunshine, but I'm not going to play that one. I'm going to play a Roy Orbison, maybe more famous guitar riff. Three, four, two, four.
that's the way it must be okay. I guess I'll go on home, it's late. We meet tomorrow night, but wait, what do I see? Is she walking back to me? Thank you.
All right.
Excellent. Thank you, Mike. Okay, Ellen is next. Let me get things muted and unmuted. Unmute Ellen. Okay.
I wanted to tell you, I'm going to do one song tonight, but
okay.
I wanted to let you know that on Friday this week, from 7 to 8, Cheryl will be having a program, and I will be part of it. And I know she's getting something out to let people know, but I'm looking forward to that. I'm going to sing one of my songs, and it's called You've Got the Blues. When you're saddened by the fragrance of a summer's night, you know the feeling wrong instead of feeling right. You got the blues. You got the blues. When you hear them in the cider of the neighbor's trees, see them in the shadows underneath the trees, you got blues. You got the blues. Don't try to shake them. You can't win. Just get a feeling. Relax. When you touch them in the honeysuckle's velvet bloom, hiding at the crater melon moon, you got the blues. You got the blues. Summer strike, oh, that you are drifting and unable.
Sound good, Ellen. Good job. Mm-hmm. Yes. Okay, up next is Woody, followed by Claude. So, Woody, you can unmute yourself. There you go.
After midnight, her bare feet half in the sand. Sister rolls up to greet her like a warm caressing hand. The moon lights the horizon, urging the wave to gleam. The street pales into the distance to where the sky meets the sea.
Guitar is gorgeous. Wow. As, I mean, yeah, everything about it was great. Oh, really, really
movie
nice.
Movie score.
Yeah.
One way or another.
Seriously.
Yours, Woody? Be the first.
It's really good. It's gorgeous, Woody.
Oh, thank you.
You, that was a Brad Paisley tune.
You are the man.
It's our man.
No, I said the man.
Hey, man.
Thank you very much.
Okay, Claude is next, followed by Mom. So you can unmute yourself, Claude. I assume you're there. I hadn't actually checked.
Yes, I'm here.
Okay.
I unmuted myself. Now, this time, I think the backing track will work. What I realized is I needed to use Rogue Amoeba's loopback to get the output of Reaper to be the input to Zoom, which is the trouble I had last night at the PCA open mic. So I hope this works a little better. Okay, so here we go. So now I guess I, it's two?
Two.
Two. Okay, so here we, gonna go to. Thank you.
McLeod. Okay, next up is Mom. After Mom will be Carla, and then Ron, I see you've signed on, and I'll put you on after Carla. So let me mute. Mom, you can unmute yourself when you're ready. Are you muted? I think you're still muted. I'm not hearing you.
Okay.
There you go. There you go.
Now?
Yep, you're fine.
Okay. As I told Woody earlier, I loved the Facebook post he put up of the Statue of Liberty whacking a couple of Washington suits. And and I decided to read the poem I had once written about the Statue of Liberty. It might be called A Lament for Our Immigrants. Our Lady of Liberty, cover your eyes. Your huddled masses do not breathe free. They cower in cells. They molder in sties. Of liberty, this is a mockery. Our Lady of Liberty, cover your ears. Terrified children torn from families are not what you would have wanted to hear. What justifies these atrocities? Our Lady of Liberty, what has become of our founding fathers' noble ideals? We can no longer be rightly known as the home of the brave and the land of the free. These are the evils of slavery enforced by the power of tyranny. And having gotten into the ranting mood, I decided to vent in the other poems that I'll read. And this one is a call to the colors, an ode to racists. How mournful are all white bouquets compared to colorful floral displays. How unappealing the all white plate of cauliflower, rice, and fish to our palates. Albino animals, we don't think pretty. We consider them odd. They excite our pity. Why then do we struggle and plot and connive to be an all white, pasty faced, anemic tribe? I put this query to ardent racists who hate the sight of different faces and want an exclusive society with no interesting variety. Let's chord the song. Let's add new notes. Who knows? We might just like these folks. And then
fantastic.
I'll do a third if I'm allowed, since they're short. And this is this is aimed at the cause of it all. It's called Freak Show. Why do we sit at our circus seats watching a shaggy yellow-haired ape swagger and strut his pompous stuff? Hear all the dissonant noise he makes. Does he mean us harm? Is that a stick of dynamite or sugar cane? And is that a cigarette lighter he points and waves at us? Why don't we boo and hiss until they drag him off the stage? We like to play with fire. We love to tempt the bull, wave the red cape, run our outdated nuclear reactors, and ignore the winds of a blackening hurricane. I'll let you off now. You can go back to happier.
Can we nominate you for Poet Laureate?
Exactly. Very powerful and relevant poems.
Those are good.
Those are great, Mom. Okay. Carla, you are next.
Okay.
And you can unmute yourself.
I'm unmute.
You are.
And I'm going back to my book of poems from 2017. Called Intimacy with the Wind, and I'm going to read you less than two songs worth of poems from this book. And this is called Moving Slips. And I wrote this because I send out a blog periodically when we're traveling in our solar powered houseboat, which is right there. And in 2015, we were on Lake Champlain and we were nomads. And I said that I had to move slips the next day in my blog. But somebody whose language, first language, wasn't English came back to me and said, what does that mean? Okay, so that's what inspired this poem. Moving slips. They swished against her dress or skirt as she moved, one leg following the next, like the eyes behind her as she walked. When she died, we picked up the folded slips, still scented, a faint of lavender, the pinks, the beiges, the fulls and halves, and boxed them for goodwill. Today I moved slips. I worried over the moves I would make for a day and a night, one handle of future I thought I could control. First I would reverse, straight and clear, leave the one slip behind before I would turn and drive toward the next. But wind, no matter how much I plan, has the upper hand. When she blows hard enough to knock, all I can do is react. And the next poem I'm going to, thank you, the next poem I'm going to read is also about immigration a little bit. And it's called Volunteering with the Immigrant Mothers. The immigrant mother I work with sits like a good girl in front of the computer. To her, the screen is wallpaper, the monitor a piece of furniture. Microsoft calls it wallpaper. She doesn't take it in. The mothers all have smartphones, but these computers are big and boxy. They take up space. The donated discards have no representation in their lives. How do I convey that a computer is a tool like a nail file, that what they do on one computer, they can do on another? This obedient mother has no idea why she is seated in front of a monitor. Her face is blank. She clicks when I say click here and hunts the keyboard when I ask her to type. When I ask her to save her work, again, blank, she hunts. Why? What can be saved? The save icon looks like a floppy disk, a relic none of these mothers has ever seen. My student is oceans away from her original home. She types her story as one long sentence. I have two children, Jason and Laura. They go Plimpton school. She knows her story by heart. She doesn't know why she has to tell it to a computer. And I am also, I've been reading some poems about my father lately. So this is another one, actually about both my parents. It's called Asparagus. A few minutes after hanging up, my father calls back to tell me three new asparagus are coming up. I had started a patch from seed at my parents' house years ago. Now my father calls me every time a spear pokes through. With each call, I'm reminded of my shortcomings and feel inept. I'm not sure why. The soil in that corner of their yard is rich. The crop had barely started to yield when I moved to a land that forbids overwintering. I tried, but the transplants failed in Florida. When I moved back north, I tried to transplant again. This time, the original patch was so dug in, I could not hack off enough root for the plant to take. Or maybe it didn't stand a chance with the woodchucks and voles. I still plan to dig up some more asparagus plants the next time I visit my father. And here the generations are, water and soil and seed, not much bigger than coriander, but smooth as a bearing. Years and years of waiting, watching, missing the ones that race to flower and recede. The key is to catch the plant when it's young. before it really roots in. Now my father gets mature spears. When he finds one just 3 inches tall, he gambles on the optimal time to pick. If he waits too long, he says, it goes to seed. What to do with this girl? I learned to grow raspberries, but not to build fences. I once battled a groundhog with a shovel in a world full of groundhogs. I dreamt my mother helped me dig up some of the plants, and instead of asparagus, she rose from the ground, full, fleshy, green. And I think I'll end with one more that is also about my father, and it's called Learning to Ride. One, those who can and those who can't, the able and the incapable, a separable set, but every day, someone on this earth makes the leap, balance and momentum, and learns to ride, how to lean into a turn and not ground. Two, there was a girl whose father told her it was time to remove the extra wheels. She was afraid she would fall off, but her father ran with her and her blue bike as he told her how he never rode a bike as a boy, growing up poor in the city. He had no need to learn. His parents couldn't even afford his new shoes. So, when he was 22 in graduate school, he taught himself to ride on a country road. The day he understood rolling resistance and that two wheels attached to a frame are inherently stable when set in motion, and she kept on pedaling when he let her go. Three, most people learn to ride as children, but some never learn. Like the woman who grew up in Mumbai. She sees her young son, master, his, and stares forlorn into the space once occupied by her son and his bike. That's everything. Thank you.
Thank you, Carl.
That's a wonderful.
Thank you.
Wonderful.
Those are all from my book, Intimacy with the Wind, which you can get on Amazon if you want. Let me know.
I'd have a copy. Okay, Ron Israel, you are up next. It's a two-song night, so I'm going to mute, and you can unmute yourself.
Okay, can you hear me?
I can.
Okay, here we go. Put on my colored glasses, I get a world I wanna see. It's a land of milk and honey, not the face of poverty. When I put on my colored glasses, when I put on my woolen stockings, the earth seems soft beneath my feet. Sunny skies, open highways, not so lonely, dead end street. When I put on earbuds, put in voices, start start to sing. I hear guitars hitting high notes. Not the sound of bombs falling. When I put on, when I put on, when I put on my brand new earbuds, now they offer great protection. Take the money that we all earn, so the world escapes inspection, and we don't have to be concerned. When I put on, when I put on, when I put on. I would say thank you. Ever since Trump got elected, I've written a whole bunch of political songs. That was kind of one of them. This is another one. That's kind of relevant, given what's happening, I think. Sorry. The moment stands the protester, crossing over a border, challenging an old order, speaking into a storm, defending your right to be here, defending your right to be free. Defending what you believe in, your humanity. Don't let him be there alone. 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 She has the strength of her conviction, the courage to stand up, say the leader ain't a leader, enough is enough. Don't let her be there alone. 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 Their fight is your fight too. First they'll arrest the protester, go after what they stand for, and then they go after you. So don't let them be there alone. 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 They speak truth to power. Don't back down in this our darkest hour. The protester stands their ground. Don't let them be there alone. Don't let them be there alone. them be there alone. Don't let them be there alone. Today the world is grieving, so much despair, needing something to believe in, to protest what's going down here. Don't let them be there alone. Don't let them be there alone. Don't let them be there alone. Don't let them be there alone.
Great song. Okay, I'm gonna finish things up. I've been digging out some older songs. This is one that I wrote for a Songwriters in the Round, where the audience, previous month's audience, gives you a prompt and you have to write a song for that. And that month the prompt was In 20 Years. And I wasn't very enthusiastic about looking ahead 20 years. Apparently, looking ahead 2 years wouldn't have been very good either. So I went back 3,000 years.
Close enough.
To a 20-year period. It's called Penelope. Try that again. She sits by the window, rocking a baby, alone in the room, staring out at the sea. Sings to her child, "Your father, the king, has gone to the war, but he'll come back to me. He'll battle the gods, but he's clever and brave. Though it take 20 years, he'll return on the waves to the peace of our olive tree bed." She stands in the doorway, calls to her son. "The messenger tells me the war has been won. The walls have been breached, towers torn down. Your father has sailed. He's on his way home. Though giants and whirlpools and witches delay, he'll win his way home at the end of the day. I've ruled for 10 years, but I'll give back the crown. He'll see how we've prospered, see how you've grown, and he'll rest in our olive tree bed." She sits at her loom, whispers her plan. "In 20 years, a boy grows to a man. The nobles are restless, your father's still missing. They say I must marry. The land needs a king. Well, I've done all I can to play for more time. Now you string his bow, I'll pour the wine."
But I dream that tomorrow he'll stride through the door and some inhale as when he went to war. Prove to the people, prove to the people he's come to no harm. Slaughter the suitors, take me in his arms, and we'd rest in our olive tree bed. In the peace of our olive tree bed.
Beautiful.
Nice.
Very good.
Great song.
This is another one that's written from a prompt, but I don't think I'm going to tell you what the prompt was. You might be able to figure it out from the song, or not. Claire is leaving in the morning. Catch a plane to Paris, France. Hang out in the corner cafe. Walk the Seine, learn to dance. Maybe she will write a novel. Read the works of Baudelaire. Come the morning sunrise.
I want to make him.
Say goodbye to Claire.
I want to make him play. Watch out for my
Claire leaving in the morning. Sail a ship across the sea. Ride a camel down the Nile. Scale the heights of ecstasy. Set out on the wandering highway journeying. God knows where, but come the morning sunrise, say goodbye to Claire. And the stars will be diamonds in the desert sky above. The moon a lantern on the path to true love. Walk by her apartment, call her on the phone. If you're looking for her, Claire will be gone. Leaving any day now. Hear the tolling of the bell. Leave the dishes in the sink. Tell the boss, go to hell. Instead of waiting for the bus, fly to meet the Southern Cross. Before her deepest dreams are lost, say goodbye to Claire. Say goodbye. Say goodbye to Claire. Okay, so that's it for tonight. I will put up the sign-up sheet the next day or so, and see most of you next week or same time.